Welcome to this afternoon's degree conferral ceremony from Memorial Chapel on the Colgate campus, Sunday, May 17th, 2020. To the family members, the parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, brothers, and sisters, and friends who join us today, welcome and thank you. To the trustees who join us and alumni who have joined us as well, welcome to you and thank you. To the Colgate faculty, also watching this afternoon, thank you for bringing a group of students to this moment. This is your day as well, so welcome to you all. But welcome most of all to the Colgate University class of 2020, whose accomplishments we mark today and for whom we are gathered in these unusual, though important, circumstances. Universities gather for teaching and for research, and they are gathered and enlivened by friendship and engagement, for challenges and the resolution of those challenges. Members of university academic communities also gather for celebration and to mark the completion of one's studies. This university has done so for over two centuries, and that is why we gather, even in these circumstances, for today's graduates, this class, to recognize your efforts, to celebrate your achievements, and to confer upon you your degrees. I met most of you on a warm August day in the summer of 2016. It was move-in day at Colgate, and you and your families had rushed Whitnall Field with cars and SUVs full of all your things, and I was there to meet you. I had only arrived at Colgate a few weeks before you did, and I went down to meet you that morning, a new president wearing a new maroon tie, this tie. And I was walking across the fields that morning, and I spoke to your parents while you stood nearby, mortified, but I could see you. And at some point in the conversation that morning, either your father or your mother or your aunt would ask me, "Where is West Hall?" Or, "How do we get to Andrews Hall?" And being new myself, I had absolutely no idea. So I'd always just answer, "Oh, it's up the hill. It's up the hill." And then you and your families would start the walk up that hill. Well, you walked up the hill that day. And 3 days after that first walk, you walked up the hill to hear your first formal speeches in this chapel. It was to you that I offered my first formal address at Colgate, in this space, in this spot, in this our chapel. And I looked out on you on that warm evening, and you were dressed up, and you looked so young and so anxious, but you looked very, very happy, and the music was playing, and the faculty was on the stage with all their regalia. And it was your beginning. And that was the first time I thought to myself, sitting there looking at you, excuse me, that's my class. There they are. We're just starting out, and we are in this together. And we were. And day after day, you kept climbing that hill, on good days and on hard days, on complicated days and on stressful days. Not one of you had it easy every day. Not one of you was spared your challenges. Every one of you had backpacks filled with so many things. And the world was not easy in your 4 years, but you kept climbing. And you have made it to such great heights. You made it to today. For several months now, I've been thinking about what I was going to say to you on your commencement day, my class. And I knew there were so many things I wanted to say to you. I wanted to congratulate you. I wanted to wish you well. And I wanted to tell you to go take on the world, to change it, to make it better. And I wanted to wish you luck and happiness. But I also wanted to tell you that I loved you, and that in ways you will never fully know, you were important to me. You were with me as I was climbing this hill, on my good days and on my harder days. We were in this together, and being with you and being part of you made it possible. It made it wonderful. And as I thought of all the things I wanted to say to you on your commencement day, I knew the one thing I did not want to say to you was goodbye. Well, this is not goodbye. It turns out our goodbyes will be for another day, on another warm morning, when we're gathered again by our lake on the bottom of our hill, where the goodbyes will be softened with hellos, and I'm so glad to see you again. But today is the day to mark your achievements, to recognize the paths you took, to honor the ways you climbed, a day of complications, no doubt. But beyond, far beyond these complications, are your achievements, your work, your walks up this hill. These are yours always, no matter what. And that is why, in rooms across the world, we gather again as a university in this new way, to welcome you into the company of educated men and women, to welcome you as alumni of Colgate University, to mark the end of your college days, to award you your degrees. But before I confer your degrees on you, let me please read to you excerpts from one of my favorite poems, Maya Angelou's A Brave and Startling Truth. We, this people, on a small and lonely planet, traveling through casual space, past aloof stars, across the way of indifferent suns, to a destination where all signs tell us it is possible, it is imperative that we learn a brave and startling truth. And when we come to it, to the day of peacemaking, when we release our fingers from fists of hostility and allow the pure air to cool our palms, when we come to it, then we will confess that not the pyramids were their stones set in mysterious perfection, nor the gardens of Babylon hanging as eternal beauty in our collective memory, not the Grand Canyon kindled into enchanting color by western sunsets. We will confess that these are not the only wonders of the world. When we come to this truth, we, this people, on this minuscule and kithless planet, who reach daily for the bomb, the blade, the dagger, yet who petition in the dark for tokens of peace, we, this people, on this mote of matter, in whose mouths abide cankerous words which challenge our very existence, yet out of those same mouths come songs of such exquisite sweetness that the heart falters in its labor and the body is quieted in awe. We, this people, on this small and drifting planet, whose hands can strike with such abandon that in a twinkling life is sapped from the living, yet those same hands can touch with such healing, such irresistible tenderness, that the haughty neck is happy to bow and the proud back is glad to bend. Out of such chaos, of such contradiction, we learn that we are neither devils nor the divine. When we come to it, this brave and startling truth, we will know that we are the possible, we are the miraculous, the true wonders of this world. That is when, only when, we come to it. This Colgate class of 2020, the class I came with, the class I loved, you are a wonder of the world. You are marvelous. The world is waiting for you now, watching for you as I watched over you for all these years. And so now it is my honor to confer upon you your degrees. And as I confer your degrees, even if you are in a kitchen or in your basement or in a backyard, I ask that you stand. One stands when you're being conferred your degrees. It is what is done. Give yourself that. So first, will the candidates for the degree of Master's in Art in Teaching please stand? Having completed all your requirements for the Master of Arts in Teaching from Colgate University, it is my honor to confer upon you the degree to which your efforts have led. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New York, the Board of Trustees, and the faculty of Colgate University, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Master in Arts and Teaching. Thank you, and congratulations. Now, will the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Arts please stand? Having completed all requirements for a Bachelor of Arts degree from Colgate University, it is my honor to confer upon you the degree to which your efforts have led. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the State of New York, the Board of Trustees, and the faculty of Colgate University, I hereby confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Arts. In short order, your degrees and other tokens of this university's great esteem will be sent to each of you. And please accept my congratulations on behalf of the Colgate University faculty and the Board of Trustees for your achievements. May God bless you. And we all look forward to seeing you again on this, your campus, when you come back. And I will be there on Whitnall Field with my dog, waiting to welcome you back home. Congratulations, and thank you, class of 2020. God bless.